Hello friends, this video on electrostatic potential part 4 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos till part 3 before going ahead with part 4. Calculate the potential energy at the initial point. We can calculate the potential energy at the final point, and the difference of the two is nothing but work done. Right, so now let us look at potential energy and potential energy difference once again with this perspective of work done. So now you already know what happens and what gets stored as potential energy in the charge and how that potential energy gets converted to kinetic energy and all those stuff, right? So now we will just introduce potential energy in terms of work done. Rather, we will define potential energy as well as potential energy difference. So again, we take the same scenario of the positive charge in the electric field produced by the positively charged conductor. So let us first define potential energy difference. Why? Because potential energy difference is the one which is directly related to work, right? So let us try to define potential energy difference with respect to whatever we studied so far. So according to our previous discussions, electric potential energy difference between two points is the work required to be done by an external force in moving a charge from one point to another for electric field of any charge configuration. I don't think you will have any issues understanding this definition, because this is what I have been explaining you in the previous slides. So let's have a quick review once again. So here also we saw the same thing. This was your charged particle. By itself, it will always try to move in this direction. It will always try to move in this direction, that is towards the right, because positive charges repel each other. Now, if you want to move it towards right, you will apply an external force. So when you apply an external force, a work is done. So this external force will do some work. Some work is done to take this object from this point to this point. Right? So you will do some work to take this point object, to take this charged particle from point A to point B. So this work done is nothing but your potential energy difference. Right? So it is not, please remember, work done is potential energy difference and not potential energy. You understand the difference, right? Potential energy difference means it is the difference between the potential energies at this point and the potential energy at this point, right? Now, you see, there is one another important term which I never discussed before, without accelerating. Why am I telling without accelerating? Just think of this situation. There is a charged particle, right? There is some force, say F1, which is pulling it towards right. Forget about all these things. Just listen to what I am telling. You have a charged particle. There is a force which is pulling it towards right with a force F1. Now, if you apply another force F2, which is greater than F1, but you apply this force F2 towards left, what will happen? Your charged particle will start moving towards left and it will start accelerating, because the force towards the left is very, very greater, or it is very, very high when compared to the force which is towards the right. But in this case, what are we saying? We are saying that the external force is exactly equal to the force which is due to this electric field. That means the electric field is this side, Fe, and the external force this side which you apply is equal to electric field. So when you apply exactly equal force, the body will just move very slowly. It will not accelerate. It will accelerate only when you give the external force is very, very larger than the force due to the electric field. You understand the difference, right? So here we are only talking about giving that much external force which will just make the body move. I don't want to accelerate the body. So I want only that much amount of, that minimum amount of force to be applied on this body. That is why we always say that the external force is always equal to the force which is due to the electric field on the body. Right? So I hope you understood potential energy difference. What is potential energy difference? Work done by an external force to move a charge without accelerating from one point to another for electric field of any charge configuration. So when I say electric field of any charge configuration, here I have always taken example of a long conductor carrying positive charge. So this conductor can be anything. It can be a spherical, it can be a sphere carrying some charge. It can be any arbitrary shape carrying an electric charge. And so the electric field can be of any configuration. The lines may look anything. So that really doesn't matter. So your potential energy difference concept will still remain the same. Right? I hope that I am able to make you understand very clearly what is potential energy difference. See, it is very important to understand the definitions, because your definitions build your concept. This is where you understand what is potential energy. Because as I move forward, I will start explaining you things more in mathematical terms rather than in terms of logic or in terms of physics. As we move forward, another 2-3 slides, and then we will reach and we will start solving mathematical equations, we will start deriving formulas, and we'll start solving numericals. So now that I have told you about potential energy difference, let us concentrate on what is potential energy. So how will you define potential energy? So till now we saw that work done in taking a charged particle from point A to point B will be equal to the potential energy difference between B and A, that is potential energy at B minus potential energy at A. This is what we understood from the definition of potential energy difference, right? So now my goal is to define potential energy. So what is potential energy? How will you get potential energy? I mean, this is by looking at this expression, you can say that, okay, this is potential energy of B, this is potential energy of A. So how would you define potential energy? So we can define potential energy in this way. If one of this term becomes zero, then your work done becomes equal to potential energy, right? If I say, how will you define potential energy at point B? So your work done, that is work done in taking the particle from point A to point B, will be equal to the potential energy of B only when the potential energy at point A is zero. So basically now we will define a position where we will follow the convention of considering the potential energy as zero. For example, when we talked about gravitational potential energy, at the surface of the earth, we say that the gravitational potential energy is zero. That is a standard convention which we follow. Similarly, we will, in case of electrostatic potential energy, we say that the electrostatic potential energy at infinity is zero. So electrostatic potential energy at infinity is zero. This is the standard convention which we follow. So that means if this point A is at infinity, if I assume that the point A is at infinity, in that case, if A is assumed to be at infinity, in that case, what will be UA? UA will be U infinity, that is zero. So in that case, your work done will be equal to the potential energy at point B, right? So in this case, what happens? This work done becomes basically equal to UB minus U infinity. That becomes UB. That means, how do you define this work done? It is nothing but the difference between the potential energy at infinity and point B. So in a way, you are taking the particle from infinity. You replace A with infinity everywhere. So what is W infinity B? It is nothing but the work done in taking the particle from infinity to point B, right? It is very simple. When we were writing WAB, that meant work done in taking it from A to B. So now your A is replaced with infinity. So work done in taking the body from infinity to point B is your potential energy. So this is how we define potential energy. Potential energy of a charge at a point is the work done by an external force equal and opposite to the electric force. Right? Electric force is nothing but the force due to the electric lines of force in bringing the charge from infinity to that point. Right? So this is your potential energy. So you understood what is potential energy? I mean, I just told you how do we define potential energy, because when you see your textbooks, everywhere you will find this term, to bring the charged particle from infinity to a particular point. So that is why I explained you this thing, that how did we arrive to this definition. So I hope that by now you have clearly understood what is electrostatic potential energy and what is electrostatic potential energy difference. So if you compare the two, you can see that potential energy difference is more significant. When we talk about work done, we don't talk about potential at each point. We just talk about the difference in potential energy of the two points. Okay. So when we basically come across the practical applications, we see that it is potential energy difference which is of more significance as compared to potential energy. Anyways, we'll go forward and we will now concentrate on electrostatic potential. Till now we saw potential energy. So now we will see what is electrostatic potential. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.